So what shall we do today as far as graph theory is concerned? Let's talk about directed graphs. So far we've only looked at undirected graph, and remember in Mathematica we did put the escape and then undirected edge and another escape. Remember that? Now we're going to have a directed edge. Now think about, let's just bring this into the real world, but remember graphs really are, they are abstract things. But imagine we have a road map and we represent the traffic lights at the intersections as nodes. So we have this little road and there's four intersections, the roads cross and the roads cross and the roads cross. We might find that the road going from this traffic light to that traffic light is a one-way. So you can't go driving in that direction. You can only drive in that direction. So if we have an edge between those two nodes, we put a little arrow there to indicate that this is a directed edge. It's not just an edge that connects two things. Look at me, I connect two things. No, I connected in a certain direction. And this might be a one-way in this direction, and this might be a one-way in that direction, and this might be a one-way in this direction. So all these directed, we have these directed edges. Imagine a social network, and we have people here. There's Sue, again, and Sarah, and there is, let's say, Andy, and all these people, and they are friends on a social network, and Sue, or Sarah at least, follows Sue, but Sue does not follow Sarah back. So Twitter, here we go, and Sarah follows Andy, but Andy follows Sarah as well. So don't worry about this notation for now, it's just a concept, so don't be too concerned with what I have there. And then Sue doesn't follow Sarah, but Sue does follow Andy. So you can imagine this network of people following each other in a social network. We can think about people who write the research papers together, and then, you know, who's connected there. We can look at the road traffic grid here. There's so many things. If we have pipes that flow gas in a certain direction, or water in a certain direction, sewage in another direction, and another pipe, there are so many things that you can, that can be represented by graphs. Remember, as I always said, these are abstract objects. We just use them in the real world. But in short, this is what directed graphs are concerned. The edges have a direction to them, and you can't travel back along that edge. So that makes this node not, in a certain way, not connected to that edge, certainly in that, to that node, certainly not in that direction. And that's going to become very important when we do paths and trails through these graphs, that to get from this node to this node might be impossible because you can't get there. And if this was a one-way in this, or it was a one-way in that direction, both these edges end up in that node and there's nowhere else. There's no way out of that node. And that's something very specific or very, very important. And we'll certainly have a look at that in the future. So here we are in Mathematica, and very short and simple, just going to show you three lines of code, and we're just going to create some directed graphs. So by now you would think that it's quite easy to guess at what the proper function is going to be, and indeed it is directed graph. So there you see I've tapped down to it, and I'm going to hit tab and tab completion, directed graph. And let's make some directed edges. I'm going to do an edge list. Node number one, I want to go to node number two in that direction. So instead of UE, undirected edge, I'm going to say DE for directed edge. You can see the line of code there. You could also have typed this backslash and then inside of square brackets, the directed edge. But doing escape, DE escape, gives you that directed edge. So that has to go to 2. I want 2 to go to 3, and I want 3 to have a directed edge back to node number 1. Back to node number 1. I'm going to close that, close, and let's have a look. And beautifully you see, I have my 3 nodes or vertices, I have the edges between them, but they are now directed edges. Now, we didn't put vertex labels here, but you can well imagine node 1 with the edge to 2, 2 to 3, and 3 back to 1. I could do the exact same thing, just thinking back at a cycle graph. Remember the cycle graphs? I'm going to say a cycle graph with 3 nodes, please. And what I'm now going to say is directed edges, and I want that to be true. So it is just going to decide. It's a cycle, remember, cycle graph, so it's going to go all the way around, and I get the exact same thing. That is a cycle graph with directed edges. Let me show you one more before we get into later on in the course about the deeper issues as far as directed graphs are concerned. Let's make a little table. We're going to make a table of cycle graphs. So let's have cycle graph, and let's cycle through a couple of them. Cycle through cycle graph. So I'm going to have the placeholder I. I'm going to say directed edges to be true. And I want to show you something else. Let's add a style to our edges. Edge style. And I'm going to say edge style arrowheads. Tab down. Arrowheads. Arrowheads can take an argument. The argument I'm going to give it is medium, to have medium-sized arrowheads. So I can change the way things look here in this graph. And that what this makes makes Mathematica very powerful, the way that you can manipulate the graphs and plots that you do. So that is medium. And then I want a plot label to each of these. I want each of these cycle graphs with directed edges that I'm going to draw to have, at least to have a plot label. And the plot label, I'm going to say it's a cycle graph, and I'm going to say sub. So it's either control underscore or command underscore, and then I. Remember, I was my placeholder. So I'm going to close that. And remember, I want I. Let's take I going from 3 to 6. So 3, 4, 5, 6. And close. So you can see what happens here. On the outside, it's a table. It's a table function here. And it has this placeholder I, which is not I squared or I plus 2, anything. It's just I. And I is going to go from 3 to 6. So 3, 4, 5, 6. So first time around, it's going to be 3. It's going to draw a cycle graph with 3 edges. Directed edges is true. And I'm going to have some edge style. So this edge is going to have a certain style with a medium arrowhead. And each one of these 3, 4, 5, and 6 is going to have a label. And it's going to be in this format C with an underscore. Let's see what this looks like. And that's beautiful. So there's C3. So you see the plot label up there. C sub 3, C sub 4, C sub 5, and C sub 6. And you can clearly see the nature of these directed graphs. They are cycle graphs. So that's the way to do directed edges in Mathematica. Play around and create some interesting edges and see how far you can get.